I grew up in the city, went to normal school, was very active, did a lot of sports. I just loved the outdoors from a young age. Went to study computer and electronic engineering. Then I went to go work in Cape Town for a few years, sort of between a few jobs. Ended up at a medical company where we did work on medical equipment. We wanted to just have our own vegetable garden in our apartment at that time in Stellenbosch. We didn't have a lot of space, so I was looking at different methods to grow our own vegetables because we couldn't really find any good organic vegetables close by. And around that time I realized that my passion was in agriculture, soil health specifically, but just everything regarding natural ecosystems and natural processes. This passion of mine just really developed and just sort of exploded, and I realized that's the only thing I want to do with my life is spend time in the soil and in nature. My name is Van Wyk. Together with my dad, we are partners of Favour Farm. Me and my wife live on the farm and we run the day-to-day business of the farm. Biointensive farming basically means two things. So we focus on soil microbiology rather than the chemical compounds in the soil and the chemical makeup of the soil. It's an intensive system. We don't use tractors. We don't plow big fields. So it's mostly done with hand, with very intensive spacing for our crops as well. When we arrived here and we started looking at the soil, we were struggling to find any earthworms. And now if you just pull one plant out of the soil, you'll find like five or six just at the root zone. So it's small things like that where you can really see a difference. I think bird species has increased so much in the past 2 years. A lot of it is things that we can't really see. It's in the soil, the biodiversity, the small microorganisms. So we try to do things as diverse as possible. I think that's the main objective. We know that nature is diverse, and so we don't really want to monocrop anything. So that's why we have different enterprises on the farm. That's the main idea behind having a diversity, not just in crops, but in animals and in different species on the farm. So within that, we have a few different enterprises. The first enterprise is a market garden where we grow our no-dig vegetables. We have a mixed flock and herd of cows and sheep. We have about 19 cows, one bull. You can hear them in the background, and a few sheep as well. We have two batches of layers. We have a few honeybees. So we have five beehives. We only have four pigs at the moment. They eat the vegetable scraps. We have accommodation, three cottages and two glamping tents. It's an amazing opportunity for people to stay on a regenerative farm and to experience the quietness. So we are completely off-grid. We don't have any municipal water. We have our two rainwater catchment dams, and we also have a borehole that we use for water. So all of our roof catches rainwater and it goes into rainwater tanks, which we use in the houses. We have a completely off-grid solar system, which powers the whole farm. It's only been running for about 3 months now, but it looks promising. We'll see how the winter goes. But we actually cancelled our Eskom contract, so there's no going back. There's a lot of studies being done regarding yield of regenerative farms versus conventional farms, which as far as I understand, is the regenerative farms are not that far behind conventional farms. And if you carry on your practices in a few years, it'll actually exceed conventional practices. So I don't believe for one second that we can produce more food that if it's grown conventional than regeneratively. But I do believe that we should have more small farms close to towns. Even people that has a small garden at home should grow their own food. So I think like decentralizing our food system is probably the answer to feed everyone. The responsibility really lies with the consumer. If you support these small ecological farms, then more of these farms will start to appear, and we'll have a healthier country. We'll have a healthier ecosystem everywhere we go, and we will see less extinction, especially like microorganisms, the small stuff, not even just the big animals. And so I think you as a consumer can make a big difference by what you buy.